Daniel Armbruster is joining us this morning. Daniel, what tips do you have for those folks who actually do have to get out in this type of weather?
Hey, good morning, Tashara. Yeah, so if you do have to get out, and most folks should not get out, as you said, but if you do have to get out, you're of course going to want to reduce your speed significantly. The roads are extremely slick this morning. And so, you know, if you do find yourself getting into a skid, even careful and experienced drivers can find themselves in a situation where they're skidding. So you want to continue and look in the direction you want your car to go, and you want to avoid slamming on the brakes. That will just further upset your vehicle's balance, make it harder to control. So when you're out on the roadways, just ease off the brakes if you feel like you're losing control, and steer and look in the direction you want to go. But the biggest thing, Tashara, is just do not panic.
One of the things, Daniel, that you just mentioned, and I want to point that out, folks who are maybe from areas where they have experienced this before and they feel like, yes, they are experienced drivers, but I feel like once you get on black ice, I don't know how much that experience really pays off. Can you speak to those folks who are living in Texas now who feel like, oh, it's fine to go ahead and get out on the roads?
Certainly, we have a lot of folks who have moved here over the past few years. But one thing to note is that the roadways here, of course, they're treated. But that doesn't necessarily mean that, as you pointed out, there won't be accumulation still on the roadways. There could be black ice. Certainly, if there's snow, it can melt and then refreeze. And then that becomes very slick as well. So certainly, you can see here, this guy, he needed some kitty litter. He didn't have that to get in his driveway. And that's a great way to eat up your tires, which are so important during this time, to have good tires, have good traction, making sure you're checking your air pressure in your tires. The cold air can really take away your air pressure. So you want to make sure you're doing that and making sure you're checking your tread. One way to check your tread, Tashara, is to take a quarter, turn it upside down, put it in between the tread. If you can see Washington's head, the top of his head, your tires are not safe enough to drive, especially in these types of conditions.
You know what? I really hope my friends that are down here from the Midwest that are living here are up listening to this. I know they're not, but I'm going to record it and try to get it out there. Did AAA's call volume see a big increase over the weekend?
We saw about a 10% increase. And, you know, the top three reasons we saw calls were tows for people who had skidded off the roadways, but also dead batteries and flat tires. Mm. And so both of those situations, the cold weather can really have an effect on your battery. It makes the fluids inside your battery thicken up. And you have to have a fully charged battery to be able to turn over your engine right now in these types of conditions. So it's really important, if your battery is over 3 years old, to get it checked by a trusted technician before you go on any kind of road trip, because Tashara, right now is the least amount of time. If you're going to have an emergency on the roadway, you don't want to have one right now. The temperatures are just too dangerous.
Briefly, Daniel, can you mention what we talked about before we came on the air about having gas in your tank?
Yeah, so it's really important that even if you're not going to be out driving, to have at least half a tank of gas in your tank, because your gas line can freeze up. Now, if you're not going to be out driving over the next few days, right now it's just better to stay home at this point. But if you can, get at least half a tank of gas in your fuel tank.
All right, Daniel Armbruster with AAA Texas. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.